My friends, good morning. It's me, President Taft's Secretary of Minecraft, and you already know what time it is. Today, the second Minecraft 1.20 snapshot 23w13a dropped with some stuff. Today, we'll talk a little bit about that and some info that we have on a new boss, too. Yeah, that's right. So last week's snapshot was a very, very big one. Monstrous, even. Huge. We got a brand new plant. We got new armor trim. We got new structure. We got sniffer stuff. Yeah, it was a lot. One of the most bugged things of all time was the pitcher plant. Inside of that snapshot, if you bone mealed it like we found out, it would just like skip right ahead, cutting through all of these middle stages. This stage I've never seen before. That stage, same thing I'd never seen before. That thing is fully grown. Also, inside of that snapshot, if I broke the farmland, it would stay, which was such a cool concept. It was clearly insanely, insanely bugged. Shouldn't work like that at all. But at the same time, I don't know about you, but I think that looks so good. If only there was a way to actually like keep this thing somehow, maybe like use it in a build or something. Because that bottom of the pitcher plant, or heck, even like the middle models of it, they look so good. Almost better even. And it's beautiful looking. I've been messing around with these 1.20 snapshots quite a bit. A couple interesting things I've noticed. The torch flower is way smaller than it looks, and the pitcher plant is way bigger than it looks. Also, I mean, I get it, we can't put two tall flowers inside of these pots right there, but come on, come on. I mean, come on, maybe now is the time to like change that. It would look so good in that pot. Directly related to Minecraft's newest plant, we've gotten Minecraft's first dinosaur. Interestingly, this mob is still not breedable with the pitcher pot. That should totally change, I feel like. I mean, logically, if the torch flower seeds work, why not any of the seeds that this thing digs up? It's interesting. When it comes to the sad sniffer, there were many problems with this thing when you put it on ice. Like that walking animation, so clean right there, it was messed up, and pathfinding problems too. But as we can see here, Minecraft's best dinosaur, and also maybe best animated mob in the entire game, doesn't seem to really have those problems anymore. It moves perfectly fine. Hands down, one of the best features in last week's snapshot has to do with this editable sign thing. Editable signs and also double-sided signs, it's something that people have been wanting for the longest time. In last week's snapshot, we talked all about how you can dye these things. It's beautiful. Previously, if you were to access this thing from any angle, you would just be thrown into the backside of the sign. Now, if we access it from an angle, but we're still clearly on the front, we access the right side, and same thing with the back. If we access the thing from the exact middle, I guess it's the front. I didn't see anything about this on the changelog, but is this bug fixed? It should be glowing right there. It ruins my immersion, and it makes the game really, really bad. Didn't see anything about this either, but I'm curious, if we wax it and then we try and strip it. No, you don't strip it. Okay, fair enough. Inside of the snapshot, we're also looking at some bug fixes related to the hanging sign as well. Unfortunately, not including how absurdly expensive this thing is to craft. Alright, so far into the snapshot video, you're probably thinking to yourself, lad, what are you doing talking about bug fix after bug fix? I don't care. Well, you should care. And interestingly, this snapshot is like literally almost entirely bug fixes. But I think I know exactly why, and it's nothing to concern. The only new thing inside of the snapshot is a nice quality of life change. Inside of the settings, if we go video settings and hold down control and scroll, we can actually adjust the GUI just like that. That means, like, maybe you have the wrong GUI, you don't need to, like, chase this button around on the screen anymore. Just hold down control and scroll to the one that you want. It's legit such a small thing, or big if I scroll that way, but I like it. I really like it. It's such a nice thing. Inside of this wonderful snapshot, we also have a few bug fixes going on with the camel. It's something that I hate to say it, but I kind of completely forgot about the camel being in 1.20. I love how they're developing this update. It's awesome. Theoretically, we had a camel sitting down. Sometimes it could sit down and kind of like swim in the water. It was a little bit strange looking. And then also, camels had a strange animation. You see, when I hit this camel, it kind of like freaks out. The legs go crazy or whatever. If you put it into an entity somehow, like a boat, while it was doing this, it would like spaz out big time. How could I forget? How could I almost forget? I'm sorry. I'm all over the place today. Despicable. Baby sniffer. The baby sniffer has a brand new model, or at least I think it should. The head should be a little bit bigger to match Bedrock Edition's one. Previously, Java's was just scaled down. It looked kind of lame, but like with the big head, adorable baby sniffer. So sweet. Yeah, wonderful. Oh my god, they sound amazing too. I've never heard that before. That's so cool. Take a look at this right here. Do you notice anything different? No? Well, maybe take a look at this right here. Mm-hmm. We're holding the brush completely differently. Previously, the brush was held in the middle, kind of by the feathers. That's a little bit intense, if you ask me. Also, we should have a fix when it comes to the direction that these particles are being thrown when we brush this thing with the offhand. You see they're being thrown over that way, and then that way, and then that way. The attention to detail is insane. Alright, heck, why not? Back to the sniffer for 1 second. Your eyes deceive you. I'm not taking out any sniffers right here, but also, while I'm taking out these sniffers, I'm not getting any moss blocks at all. It's something that I noticed from messing around with this thing, but kept forgetting to say in a video, but yeah, the sniffers actually had a small chance to drop the moss block. I don't know why it was like that, but it's not like that anymore. They don't do it. That's gonna mean that the sniffer officially has zero drops whatsoever. When you take this thing out with 2 critical hits, theoretically, from a netherite sword, you get nothing, so don't do that. You're a monster. And that was all, like, not real, okay? Don't get mad at me. Next up, I'd like to test something secret. We talked about it in this video right here. I'd like to see if the state is still here. If we scroll through this, cracked, true, and false. It definitely is still here. Cracked, true, cracked, false. What in the world could that mean? Oh, that's interesting. Minecraft snapshot 23w13a, the second 1.20 snapshot. It's all about bug fixing, polishing, cleaning up last week's big gigantic snapshot. It's maybe not the most exciting thing in the world, but this is, I would say, a good thing. If 1.20 is gonna come out beginning of June, well, if that's the case, then a snapshot like this that cleans up last week's snapshot and maybe even gets everything feeling a whole lot more complete, well, that's a good thing. Every single year on April 1st, Mojang plays a little goof, a gag, if you will. April 1st is coming up, it is on Saturday. There's no way to know for sure, but the snapshot could also be small, because they're finishing polishing up this week's April Fool's joke. What could it be? Ah, well, hopefully anything other than the screensaver. In a couple days' time, we'll know for sure. With this snapshot out of the way, let's head over to the official Minecraft YouTube channel, where, just like me, they've been posting shorts. We will find a beautiful things. We'll find beautiful things like that over on the channel. Some of these shorts that have been posted with the developers get pretty interesting. We get interesting insights and looks into Minecraft's development and what the devs are thinking going forward. This was an interesting one from Jeb, talking all about invisible blocks in survival Minecraft. You know, something like the barrier, but not quite a barrier. I imagine it as something that you could use as a placeholder, kind of like how we use string now to maybe stop something from growing. Jeb said, probably not, but maybe if they did, they would differentiate it in some way. Like, you look at it, and it looks different. Out of all of the shorts so far, they've been really interesting. This is a topic that I've been holding on for a while because it's so small. It's not worth a full video. But seeing as the snapshot leaves us a little bit extra time today, look at this.
Giovanni?
Speechless. I'm completely, wholly, and fully speechless. That was clearly a nod. That was like that. And that means yes. Now there's no chance in the world this is a hint at Minecraft 1.20. Like, the update has gotten so big, there's no way next week they add a boss to Minecraft. But that would actually be really, really cool. But the mere fact that they are communicating directly on their official channel that there is hopes for a new boss in Minecraft and they do have those plans, that's breathtaking. That's a topic you might hear me talk a little bit more about in the future, but for today, I think that's gonna cut it. 23W13A, everything. I'm sure next week we can expect a bigger snapshot, and also this weekend is April Fool's. Smash sub so you don't miss out. For more snapshot videos, drop a like, and next up, I highly recommend yesterday's video, where we took a look at trail ruins and all of their interesting complexities. Thanks for watching. I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.